Hello, can anyone unmute yourself? Hello, can you hear my voice? Hello. Okay. Actually, how many students are there total? Any idea for anyone? As for now, only 7 students have joined. Okay. Shall we start or we have to wait for 5 more minutes? Hello. So good morning, everyone. So today's session, we are going to discuss about the pest of groundnut and sesame. So we can start, right? Okay. So first, let's see about the pest of groundnut. The first foremost pest is red hairy caterpillar. So the scientific name is Amsecta albistriga or Amsecta mori. That comes under the family Apteridae and the order Lepidoptera. So this pest is also known to attack young sorghum, maize, cotton, castor, cowpea, and also bajra. So once this pest attacks the field, they will completely devour the leaves on the field. That is, they will cause defoliation. And also when you see the field, the entire crop will look as though it is being grazed by the cattle. So that is the important symptom of this pest, that is defoliation, and the crop, it will look as though it is grazed by the cattle. So next is the life cycle of this pest. So the female moth, it will lay the egg under surface of the leaves in clusters and cover these eggs with pale brown hairs. And the incubation period, it varies from 5 to 10 days. The larva, it will emerge, and the larva that emerges will be having a red head, and the body, it will be having long, dense, reddish brown hairs. And also their body, it is like a sandwich, that is both the anterior and also the posterior end, it will be having black broad bands, as you can see here in the picture. And in the middle, there will be reddish area. And the pupation, the pupa, it will be darker in color. And sometimes it will also be yellow in color. And also in pupa, there will be spiny hairs on the posterior end. And in this red hairy caterpillar, the pupa is the one which undergoes the diapause stage during the winter season. And the larval period, it varies from 15 to 85 days. And the pupal period, it will vary from 7 to 20 days. So adult, as I said, there are two species, that is albistriga and mori. So how you can differentiate between these two species? First is the albistriga. So they they will be having white forewings with a brownish streak all over. And also there will be yellow streak along the anterior margin, and their hind wing, it will be having black markings. Whereas in Amsecta mori, the forewing and the hind wing, it will be white in color, and also the forewings will be having a red color in the anterior marginal streaks. And another differentiation you can see is that the albistriga, they will be having a yellowish band on the head, whereas for mori, it will be having red color in the head. And management, first of all, you have to collect the pupa. That is, you have to destroy the pupa that is present in the field bunds and also in the shady spots. And you can set up about 3 to 4 light tracks and also bonfires immediately after the receipt of rains, which is a conducive environment for this pest. So, and also after sowing in the rain-fed season in order to attract and also to kill the moth. Then you can go for the collection and destruction of the gregarious and early instar larvae. Then you can go for intercropping with red gram and cowpea. You can also collect and destruct the egg masses in the cropped area. Then you know that these larvae, it is used to travel like with bunches. So in order to avoid the migration, you have to dig a trench about 30 centimeter deep and also 25 centimeter wide around the infested field. Then in order to control this pest, you can go for spraying with Fosilin or Dichlorovos. So next, you can also distribute the poison bait. This poison bait, it is made with rice bran 10 kg, jaggery 1 kg, along with quinolphos 1 liter or methomyl 350 ml. Which are dissolved in the water in order to make this make a ball type poison bait. And these are kept in the field in the evening hours in order to attract the pest. And also you can grow cowpea or castor as trap crops. then you have to conserve the natural enemies in the field, like parasitoid, like Trichogramma species and Enicospilus species. Then predators like Chrysoparla, ladybird beetle, redwood bug, spider, red ant, robber fly. Then birds like king crow, common myna, and also other predators like big-eyed bug, ground beetle, pentatomid bug, and praying mantis. So next pest, it is groundnut leaf myna, that is Aproerima modicella. It belongs to the family Gelichidae and order Lepidoptera. So this is also known to attack other crops like red gram and also soya bean. So the symptom of this pest is that first, initially the young larva, it will mine into the leaflet and it will feed on the mesophyll there. And this mining, they will form a small brown blotches. So after, in a later stage, they will come out of this mine and they will web the leaflets together and they will remain or reside inside that and they will feed on it. And if you see this field from a distance, you could see that the field will look like as if it is burnt. So next is the biology of this pest. So the adult moth, it will be dark brown in color, and in the forewing, in the coastal margin, you can see a white spot. And also the small, they will be having a small hind wings. It is covered by fringe of minute hairs. And the adults, they are briskly whirling around the plants in field. And after that, they will lay shiny transparent egg singly on the undersurface of the leaflet. They will lay about 150 to 200 eggs in their lifetime, which will hatch within 2 to 3 days. And the larva emerges, which will be pale brown in color, and the fully grown larva will be about 6 to 8 mm. And the larval period, it will vary from 4 to 17 days. And after that, the pupation, it will take place in the white silken cocoon within webbed leaflet itself. And the pupa, it will be reddish in color. And the pupal period, it will varies from 5 to 7 days. And on a whole, the life cycle, it will get completed by 20 to 25 days. And the adult longevity will be only for 5 to 6 days. Next is the management. So the ETL of this pest, 30 days after seedling emergence, the ETL will be like one larva per meter row, or five or more active larva per plant. And 50 days after emergence, it will be, the ETL will be 10 larvae per plant. And 75 days after emergence, the ETL will be 15 larvae per plant. So it is like 5, 10 and 15. Next, you can also go for growing resistant cultivars. Then you can intercrop this groundnut with pearl millet at the ratio of 4:1. Then you can set up light traps in order to trap the moth. Then you can mulch the soil with straw in order to conserve the moisture within 10 days after germination. Then you also have to avoid the water stress. So if there is water stress, then the pest infestation will be more. Then you have to maintain the fields and bunds free from weeds, as these weeds are also the alternative host for this pest. And you can apply carbaryl at 25 kg per hectare when this pest crosses the ETL. And also you can go for any of the following insecticide as spraying, like dichlorovers, quinolfos, lambda cyhalothrin. So next, it is tobacco caterpillar, which is the common pest seen in many host plants like citrus, soybean, cotton, tobacco, castor, pulses, millet, safflower, banana, cabbage, tomato, sweet potato, bendi, and chilies. And the scientific name, you know very well, it is Podoptera lichura. It comes under the family Noctidae, that is, it will be active during dark time, and the order Lepidoptera. So the damage symptom is that it will also feed voraciously on the leaves, and here also the field will look as though it is grazed by the cattle. So as I said, this pest is active during night. During daytime, they will hide under the plants, cracks, or crevices of soil. Then as an indicator this pest is there in the field, you can see fecal pellets on the leaves and also on the grounds. So next is the bionomics of this pest. So it is a stout moth. They will be having wavy white markings on the brown forewings, and also in the white hind wings there will be a brown patch along its margin. So these female moth, they will lay eggs in groups and cover it with the hair on the leaves. And the incubation period, it varies from 4 to 5 days. And the larva which emerges will be very much stout, cylindrical, and also pale brownish in color with dark markings. So the peculiar character is that they will be having a row of dark spots and also transverse and longitudinal gray and yellow bands you can observe in this larvae. So the larval period, it will be from 14 to 21 days, and after that they will pupate in the earthen cells in the soil, and the period will be about 15 days, and the whole life cycle it will get completed within a month. So next is the management. So the ETL of this pest is 1 to 2 egg masses per meter crop row of 7 to 12 plants, or pheromone trap catches exceeds 10 moth per night. And for management, you can grow castor as a border or intercrop, and you can go for resistant cultivars. Then in order to monitor the emergence of the adult moth, you can also set up a light trap in the field. Then you can go for setting up of pheromone trap, that is a specific pheromone that is used to trap this male moth is Ferodin SL. So you can set up at 12 numbers per hectare, and you also have to change the pheromone septa once in 3 weeks. Then you can also collect the egg masses and you can destroy it. So once you see the symptoms like lace-like leaves that appears on the intercrop or on the trap crop, you can go for the collection of the gregarious larvae and you can destroy them. So in order to avoid the migration, you can also dig the trenches. Then here also you can go for preparing the bait with rice bran, molasses, or brown sugar at 2.5 kg. Then along with it, you have to mix the insecticide carbaryl 50 WP at 1.25 kg. Then you can go for nucleopolyhedrosis virus at 250 LE per hectare with along with the crude sugar, which is as effective as that of chlorpyrifos. So then you can also spray insecticide like carbaryl, quinolphos, phentoate, and also dichlorovos. So in order to control, that is for early instar larvae, and for the late instar larvae, you can go for spraying of this chlorpyrifos, dichlorovos, same. And also you can use diflubenzuron and methomyl. So next it is gram pod borer at another polyphagous pest. The scientific name is Helicoverpa armigera. And it also comes under the family Noctidae and the order Lepidoptera. And the host range of this pest is cotton, sorghum, lab, soybean, pea, then safflower, chillis, groundnut, tobacco, okra, maize, tobacco. That is it affect, field crops, then vegetables, fruits, everything it used to feed. Then the damage symptom. So once this pest attack the field, you can observe a small or large irregular feeding holes on the leaves. And also you can see these larva wandering around in the field or on the plants. Then these caterpillars are also known to damage the fruiting bodies by entering into them. So next is the biology of this pest. So these are brown colored moth, and they will be having a V-shaped speck on the forewings, and also there will be dark black border in the hind wings, and they will lay eggs singly on the host plants, and the egg period it will vary from 5 to 7 days. And once the larva emerges, it will be like greenish in color with dark brown to gray lines on their dorsal side and also on the ventral side. And also it is being researched that the larvae, they will the color will vary according to the host plant they depend upon, and the larval period, it will vary from 14 to 20 days. And also the pupation, it will takes place in the soil. And Helicoverpa armigera is known to show cannibalism, that is, it will attack their own population. So next is the management. Here the ETL is 10% leaf damage. Then so you can, for management, you can set up a light trap in order to attract and survey the moth. Then you can go for setting up of pheromone traps at 12 numbers per hectare in order to attract the male moth. Then you can also release egg parasite, that is Trichogramma species, and egg larval parasite, that is Chelonis blackburni. Then you can also apply the viral pathogen, that is nuclear polyhedrosis virus, at 250 LE per hectare. Then you can also go for the combined use of the NPV of this Spodoptera litura as well as the Helicoverpa armigera. And also the research showed that the single application of this NPV of each pest with the crude sugar is highly effective to control this Helicoverpa armigera. Then for control, you can go for spraying of imamectin benzoate and also spinosad. Then next is the pod borer, that is earwig. Earwig is actually a predator in most of the insect, but in ground net, it is known to attack this crop. So the scientific name is Anisolabis tali. It belongs to the family Forficulidae and the order Dermaptera. So they are known to pod in, they are known to bore into the pods. And they will plug the holes with excreta or sand particles or any of the discolored pulp that they are producing. They will plug it in the holes. Then the bored holes, it will be devoid of kernel. That will, it will completely devastate the kernel that is present inside the pods. And coming to the biology, the adult, it will be dark browning colored, and you know that the forceps, they will be having forceps like caudal cerci. So it is one of the important characteristic of this earwig. They will be having forceps like cerci, and also they are having wide leg joints. And it lay eggs in clusters in soil for about 20 to 100 eggs. And sometimes they will lay the eggs also in the damaged pots. And there will be five nymphal instars, which also resembles just like that of the adult. And they can live for up to 250 days. And also their abdominal tip, it is having a forked cerci that is recognized as letter Y. And for management, you can apply Malathion 5D or endosulfan, it is banned. You can go for carbaryl prior to sowing in areas where this earwig is endemic. And also you can go for soil application of any of the dust formulation. And you can also incorporate in the soil during the earthing up. Next is the pod bug. The scientific name is Elasmolomus sordidus. That comes under the family Lygidae and order Hemiptera. So this pest is known to attack during pod maturity stage and pod harvesting stage, and also it is used to attack the harvested produce that is placed in the threshing floor. So both nymphs and adult, they will suck the sap from the pod. As a result, once you harvest the pods, you will see the shriveled kernels. So biology, this bug is dark in color and about 10 mm long and 2 mm wide. And they will lay eggs singly in the soil or on ground net horns while they are in the field. But in storage, they will lay eggs loosely among the ground nets. And the single female can lay up to 105 eggs. And the egg period, it varies from 4 to 5 days. So once the once the young one it emerges, it will be bright red in color, and later it will become darker. And this, both the nymphs and adults, they will feed on kernels by piercing the pod with their rostrum, and as a result the kernels will shrink. The nymphal period, it will be from 23 to 29 days, and this pest is also nocturnal, and it will hide under weeds, cracks and crevices in soil and also debris during their daytime. And for management, you can set up light trap to attract and kill the bugs, and you can also keep the crop refuge in the field along the irrigation channel in order to attract the bugs, which can be killed by dusting the insecticide, like any of the insecticide, systemic insecticide you can use. Then also in the gunny bag where the groundnut is being stored, you can also dust it with Malathion 4D. Next is the sucking pest, aphid. So we have learned this pest in previous classes also. So here the groundnut aphid is Aphis crazivora, that comes under the family Aphidae and order Hemiptera. It is also known to attack on beans, snaphla, lablab, niger, peas and also other pulses. Then the damage symptom is that they will both the nymphs and the adults, they will suck the sap from the leaflets. As a result, the tender shoots will wilt, and also you can observe chlorotic or dark green spots on the leaves, and the leaves will also get mottled. Eventually the plant growth will become stunted. You can also observe honeydew on the leaves, which will often attract the ants. So this aphid is a vector of peanut stripe virus and also groundnut rosette disease. And coming to the biology, as I said, this Aphis crazivora, they are having both wingless and winged adults. So they reproduce without mating, that is through parthenogenesis. The individual adult, they are capable of producing about 100 nymphs in their lifespan. And these nymphs will be dark colored, and later they will turn into shiny black adults in about 10 days. So when there are more crowd, they will create this winged forms. So for management, you have to set up a yellow streaky trap randomly in about 25 to 30 places per hectare. Then you can also go for intercropping of groundnut with cowpea in order to attract the sucking pest. Then you can also plant the maize as a border crop in order to help the multiplication of the predators like coccinellids. Then you can release the green lace wing chrysopa at chrysoperla at 2500 per hectare in order to reduce this aphid population. Then you can go for spraying of this neem seed kernel extract. Then you can also release coccinellid beetle, then egg parasitoid trichogramma. Then in order to control this pest, you can go for a spraying of monocrotophores, dichlorovores and also phosphomidone. So next is the leaf hopper. The scientific name is Empersica cari, which comes under the family Cicadellidae and the order Hemiptera. And this leaf hopper is also known to attack castor, cluster bean, maize, soya bean, green gram, black gram, cowpea and also PGNP. And the damage symptom is that once this pest desap the plant juices, you can observe whitening of the veins, and also chlorotic or yellow patches will appear, especially at the tip of the leaflets. And also under severe infestation, you can observe a V-shaped necrotic discoloration in the leaf tip that will give appearance of hopper burn. And coming to the biology, you know that it is an greenish insect, which is extremely very small. And the males, it will be more smaller and greener than the females. And the eggs, it will insert into the leaf tissue with its by thrusting its ovipositor. Mainly near the midrib and veins from the undersurface of the leaf. It used to lay the eggs in the undersurface of the trees, and also it used to suck the sap from the undersurface of the leaves. And they are broad and rounded at one end, where the nymphs will be broad and rounded at one end, and usually they used to taper towards the other end. Then the egg period, it will be from 7 to 10 days, and the nymphal period, it will be from 7 to 14 days. And for management, the ETL will be 10% damage of the leaves, that is Hopperbund symptom. So for management, you can go for intercropping with lab at 4:1 ratio. Then you can spray insecticide in order to control the pest population with monocrotophus, phoscomedin, and dimethoate. And also high degree in resistant to jacid is actually observed in groundnut genotype with hairy leaves. The one with hairy leaves will be having more resistant to the jacid. So you have to go for varieties with the higher densities of this hair. That is trichomes. Then next best is thrips, that is Scriptothrips dorsalis, Frankliniella, then Thrips palmi. So these are also a polyphagous pest known to attack drumstick, grapevine, tea, acacia, then cashews, citrus, and so many plants. Then this insect also known to suck the sap from the surface of the leaflet. So on the upper portion of the leaves, you can observe white patches, whereas on the lower surface of the leaves, you can observe necrotic patches. And these patchy areas, once the leaflets grow, it will puncture and it will split. And you can also observe the distortion of this young leaflets. And thrips, you know that it is mostly known to attack attack during the seedling stage, and it's incidence is also more in nursery. So coming to the biology of this pest, this pest is long and yellowish in color, and on the dorsum of their abdomen, there will be 5 transverse dark brown thick bands, and their forewings, it will be having few setae. So the thrips, it will lay its egg inside the leaf tissue by thrusting its ovipositor into it. And the eggs will be small and also kidney shaped, and they will hatch within 6 to 9 days. The nymphs emerges and within 2 to 3 days, and there will be 2 larval instars for this pest. And the pupation, it will occur on plants at sheltered places such as spider webs, leaf mines, and web leaf. So among hemimetabolites, only Thysanoptera is known to have a pupal stage. So next, the mating, it will takes place soon after the adult emerges from the pupa. And a single female can lay about 30 to 40 eggs in its lifetime. So this is known to be the vector of groundnut stem necrosis disease. And the ETL of this thrips is 5 thrips per terminal leaf. And for management, you can go for early sowing, and you can also spray dimethoate or any systemic insecticide. And also you can go for resistant varieties. So next is the bud borer. This is a minor pest in groundnut, that is Anarsia epipias. The family is Gelichidae, and the order Lepidoptera. So here, the larva, it will bore into the terminal buds and shoots, and also it will tunnel into the stem. So as it tunnels into the stem and feed on that, the further development of the growth is distorted. Then the larva will also bore into the apex of the stem, and the infestation of the stem shoot damages will be about 20 to 35%, and the yield will also reduce for about 5%. Actually, this pest is not so important, so there is no need to take up any management practices. And this pest, it is a buff-colored moth, and it also will be active, and it will hover around the plant anomalies during the daytime. And the larva, it will be dark in color, like chocolate brown to dark brown. So you need not have to go for management practices normally, but if it is more in any of the if its incidence is more, then you can choose any of this management, like conserving the hymenopteran parasitoid, like Brachon species and Brachymeria species. Then you can also go for spraying of the neem oil or nochi leaf extract. Then you can also spray insecticide like indoxocarp, spinosad, etc. Normally, the management practices are not being taken. They will only conserve the natural enemies in the field. Then next is the stem borer, which is also a minor pest, that is Sphenoptera peroteti, that comes under the family Bruticidae, that is, it is a jewel beetle, and the order Coleoptera. It is also known to attack sesame, gram, and also other pulses. So this jewel beetle grub, they used to bore into the stem, that is just below the soil surface, and will tunnel into the main roots. So as the result, the plants will wilt in patches. So when you open this tunnel, you can observe the elongate flat-headed grubs. And as I said, it is a jewel beetle, and their grub will be pale white in color with a flat anterior portion, and they are also known to pupate in the stem itself. And for management, you can go for spraying of this malathion or carbaryl to the hole or furrow. Then you have to repeat the same, that is, you have to spray this insecticide during earthing up, and also you have to when you go for gypsum application. So next is the white grub. This we saw in sugarcane also. So here the white grub that is known to attack the groundnut is Holotrichia consanguinea. The family is Carabidae, and order Coleoptera. So these grubs are known to attack the roots of this crop partially or fully. They will eat fully or partially the roots. And as a result, the plants will die, and you can also see the damages in patches. The plants will eventually wilt, they will die. And also whenever this pest attacks the crop, the growth of the plant is retarded. So next, it is the biomics of this pest. So both grubs and beetles, they are, you know that they are polyphagous, and the eggs, they will be laid in the soil, and it will be about at a depth of 5 to 20 centimeters. And the eggs will be pearly whitish in color, and also it will be oval, and they will hatch within 9 to 11 days. And the larva emerges, it will be translucent white. Once it finds its suitable crop plants, it will begin to feed on the rootlets. And the pupation also, it will take place in the soil. And the adult, it will come out of the soil once the monsoon starts. And also the beetle emerge from shortly after the heavy pre-monsoon or monsoon showers. And the beetle, it will be like a dark brown in color. And for management, you can go for summer plowing, as you can observe the pupa in the soil. And after that, you have to collect this pupa and destroy it. Then you can also go for early sowing of this crop. Then you have to set up light trap in order to monitor and also to collect the adult beetles and kill it. then you know that the adult beetles will be attracted to trees like neems, acacia and all. That is, this adult beetle is not the pest of groundnut. Only the grubs will feed on the groundnut. So what you have to do is, you have to collect the adult beetle from there and you have to destroy it. Then also you can spray the stem or branch of the trees like neem, tamarind and acacia trees on which this adult beetle feeds on. You can spray it with chlorpyrifos. Then you can also handpick these adult that is resting in the soil, and you have to destroy it. Then you can also go for spraying of this entomopathogenic fungi like Metahysium and Bivaria at 12.5 kg per hectare. So in order to get more, in order to be more effective, you can mix these entomopathogenic fungi with FYM and apply it in the furrows. Then you can go for a soil application with 4-8 granules. Then you can also go for seed treatment with this chlorpyrifos. Then you have to place this insecticide treated twigs near the neem or acacia on which this adult beetles will get attracted, and then it eventually will kill the adult beetles. So next is the termites, that is Odontotermus species. This also we studied in sugarcane pest. So the family, it is Termitidae and order Isoptera. So these are known to feed on the roots. Eventually the plant will wilt in patches. And it is also known to make bore holes in the pots. And also it will make the thicker portion intact by damaging the soft tissue in pots. And also these termite, it will flutter around and in the plants. So Bionomics and all we discussed in the previous pest, even though you know that it just resembles like ants. So for management, the best practice is by trenching with chlorpyrifos. You can also go for dusting methyl parathion 200 gram around. Then also you can dig up the termite mound and you can destroy this termite mound. And also you can destroy the egg laying machine, that is the queen, from the mound, which will be a permanent measure of the control. So next, let's see the pest of sesamum. So first it is gingerly leaf webber, roller and pod borer. That is the scientific name. It is Antigastra catalonalis. It comes under the family Pyralidae or Crambidae and order Lepidoptera. So here what it will do is, once the larva emerges, it will roll together the top leaves and it will feed by residing inside them. During early stage of infestation, the plant will die and it will not even produce any shoot or branches. But in a later stage of attack, it will infest the shoot that will stop growing. Then at flowering stage, the larva will be feeding inside the flowers, and during capsule formation, it will bore into the capsule and it will feed on the developing seed. That is, this pest is known to affect all the stages of the crop. So identification of this pest, these female moth, they will lay shining flat eggs on the tender parts of plant. It will lay about 100 to 130 eggs, and the incubation period will be varying from 4 to 5 days. The emerging larva, it will be greenish in color and they will be having black head, and also there will be short white hairs all over the body. And the larvae, the period, it varies from 11 to 16 days. Then the pupation takes place. It also takes place within the leaf web itself. The pupal period, it will last for about 7 to 10 days. And about the adult, it is like a medium-sized moth and it will be having reddish-yellow forewings. And for management, you can go for spraying of the neem formulation 0.03%. Then you can also go for spraying of insecticide like carbaryl. Then you can go for spraying of neem seed kernel extract, then neem oil. The important thing to be noticed here is you should not use the same insecticide every time. You have to go for alternate insecticide during each season. So next is another important pest, that is hawk or dead head moth, that is Sphinx caterpillar, Acherontia styx. So the symptom of damage, this pest is known to defoliate the plants, and the adult moth, it is also harmful to the honeybee, as it will suck the honey from the honeycombs in apiaries. And identification of the pest, the female moth, it will lay globular egg singly on the undersurface of the leaves. And the egg period is 2 to 5 days. And the emerging larva will be greenish in color, and they will be having black head having short white hairs. And also you can observe that they will be having a yellowish curved horn at the anal region. And they used to pupate in earthen cocoon in soil, and the pupal period, it will last for about 14 to 21 days. And the identification of the pest, they are brownish Jane hawk moth. And the characteristic feature of this moth is that they will be having a characteristic skull marking on their thorax. And also their abdomen, they will be having violet and yellow bands. And their forewings, it will be dark brown or reddish yellow in color. And their hind wings, you can see here, it will be yellowish in color with two black lines. So next is the management. For management, you can go for deep plowing, which will expose the pupae for predation to the insectivorous birds or other predators. Then you can also collect and destruct the caterpillar by hand picking. Then you can also go for dusting with Fossilon, Malathion at 2 rounds. One will be at 30 days after sowing, and the second one will be at the 45th day after sowing. So next is the gall fly, that is Aspondiella sisam. The family is Cicidomyidae and the order Diptera. So these maggots, they are known to feed inside the flower bud, and they will form a gall-like structure. And this gall-like structure that they developed will not allow the flowers or capsules to develop further. And this affected buds, they will wither and drop. So coming to the bionomics of this pest, so they are like Diptera, so they also looks like a mosquito, and they will lay eggs in the flowers or buds, and the egg period, it will vary from 2 to 4 days. The maggot that emerges will be white in color, and it will also be found inside the flower where it laid the eggs. And the larval period, it will range for about 2 to 3 weeks, and the pupation, it will also takes place inside the malformed capsules. The fly that emerges from this within 7 to 12 days, these flies will emerge, and the total life cycle will be about 23 to 27 days. And for management, you have to pick and burn all the shedded buds. Then you can go for resistant varieties. Then you have to go for two spraying in endemic areas. Then, you have to go for growing resistant varieties in endemic areas. Then for control measures, you have to spray with neem formulation. Then you can also go for spraying with insecticide carbaryl. Then you can go for spraying with neem seed kernel extract and neem oil. So as I said before, you should not use the same insecticide every time. So next it is leaf hopper, that is Orosius albicinctus. It comes under the family Cicadellidae and order Hemiptera. Here the leaf hopper, it will suck the sap suck the sap. As a result, the curling of the leaves can be seen, and eventually the leaves will turn red or brown in color. After that, the leaves will dry up completely and it will shed off. And this pest is important because it is a vector of Sesamum phyllodes. So Sesamum phyllodes, where the floral structure, it will be converted to leaf-like structures, and also the plants will become sterile in nature. The adult, it will be a light brown colored hopper. Other bionomics are same as normal leaf hoppers. Then for management, you have to remove the Sesamum phyllodes disease plant from the field, and you have to go for any of the insecticide like methyl dimethone or quinolphos. So next is aphid. So it is also a minor pest in this Sesamum, that is the Aphis gossypii, that comes under the family Aphididae and the order Hemiptera. So due to the continuous desapping of the plant juice, the leaves will become crinkled and also it will curl. And it will also curl. And the leaf, it appears shiny, and they will secrete honeydew, which will attract the ants. And these honeydew later, it will, the sooty mold will be formed on the honeydew. This sooty mold will block the sunlight to the plants. And the leaves will be having a black coating. So identification of this pest. So we know already these reproduce parthenogenetically. And they will be yellowish in color, then they will become a dark insect. Mostly they will be wingless, but on crowd situation, wing form will be created. Then they will be sucking the sap from the undersurface of the leaves. So as I said, the winged forms may be seen during crowded condition. And for management, you have to go for seed treatment with imidacloprid, and also you have to paint the stem with a mixture of monocotycus water or imidacloprid. Yes. So that's all for today's class. Hello. Hello.